What happened to the Black Mamba? What happened to the Lakers this season? Obviously, it seems like the Lakers couldn't, you know, make it to the playoffs. They had one less win than the Lob City Clips, so they got booted, man. Kobe, he didn't get injured. It was a lot of speculation going on. He's in the rankings. This guy, they just went on a bad losing streak, man. This guy even got player of the month in the last month in the West. So to tell you the truth, I don't know what happened to Kobe in the Lake show. But I do want to tell y'all, it's my second playoff game. Let's go.
Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. Playoff basketball on 2K Sports.
Yeah, what's going on, everybody? It's iPodKingCarter here, the Superman of YouTube. It's the second game of the playoffs for me, you guys, as I get Dwight Howard his first foul of the game. I'm starting it off early, man. I got to get Dwight Howard out of here, man. I can't stand him. But let me talk about the real NBA right quick, M-San. All right, first off, mad respect for every NBA player in the game today. The reason being, these guys had a very limited time to get prepared for this season. And due to that, a lot of injuries happened this season towards where people, you know, the whole season is gone. The playoff prowess is gone. Everything is gone, man. I'm sorry about D-Rose, you know, tearing his ACL or a knee injury, whatever they want to call it. They haven't made it official yet. I haven't seen any statements. But I have seen that Shumpert, he did tear his. So, you know, big ups to him. Hopefully, you know, he bounces back from that. Hopefully, the reigning MVP bounces back from his as well. But what I do want to say about the playoff games in general, everybody came and showed up and did what I thought that they were going to do. Now, the only games that got me were the Pacers and Magic game. I didn't know that the Magic still had it in them, even though they didn't have Dwight Howard to win out. Also, I knew that Miami was going to beat the bricks off of New York, without a doubt. I knew that the Spurs was going to show up and let the eighth seed know that they're number one for a reason. I knew that the Lake show was going to win. It's the Lake show, man. Come on. Let's keep it a bean. When it came to the Sixers and Philly, I knew that it was going to be a tough first game, especially with D-Rose back in the game and back in NBA. And, like, it was, and it truly was. But, you know, at the end of the game, he suffered a season-ending injury. And, you know, maybe some people might say we have a chance. Some people might say, oh, we're still going to lose. But I believe in my Sixers, man, either way. If we win it and go to the second round, people are going to say, oh, y'all did it while D-Rose wasn't there. It is what it is. Things happen. Now, moving on, the Memphis and fucking Lob City game. What the fuck? Who did Lob City pay off? LA got money, baby. I just want to know who they paid off. LA got money. Real talk, man. They came back and won that game. I can't believe it, yo. Also, yo, I really can't believe this shit. Real talk. But moving on, the Mavericks and OKC. Shout out to KD, man. God damn, this ball shooter's role is magnificent. Some people might say he may be the best finisher in the NBA currently. Damn, that's a lot to say about a scoring champ, ain't it? The best finisher? Damn, I thought that the Black Mamba was the best finisher. But it is what it is. Now, the Celtics and the Atlanta game. Atlanta is more athletic. We already knew that was coming in. You know, they got the home court advantage, and they showed up, man. They beat the Celtics. It's that simple. Did I miss anybody? Lake show beating the Nuggets. Jazz losing to the Spurs. Dirk and them getting handled by 1 point. I think I covered it all, right? That's every game in the book. If I missed any games, let me know. Should I do it the next video? Shit, it is what it is. But I hope you guys did like all the information I gave about Kobe Bryant and my player mode. Now, what I'm going to do for y'all, I'm going to give y'all my analysis of the second half. Right now, you can see that we down, but I'm going in the corner, shoot this fast break three. You know what I'm saying? Let's get into the halftime show, y'all.
And welcome to HP at the Half. NBA playoffs now in full swing. Let's get you to all the round one action. It's been the 76ers scrapping it out. They're looking for their second win in as many games in this series. A huge advantage in points in the paint. They're having their way inside. And Orlando also bringing it. They've been active defensively. Steals, deflections, jumping to passing lanes, forcing miscues. An impressive first half for Hidu Turkoglu. He's up to 14 points and is also working on the other end of the floor. Nice defensive work. These two have set the benchmark so far tonight, leading their teams in first half scoring. That's it here. Now let's send you back to Kevin, Steve, Clark, and Doris for the start of the third quarter.
All right, starting off in the third quarter, I still had the same game plan going in. What I wanted to do was I wanted to foul Dwight Howard out, also get Jameer Nelson out of there because I didn't really want to stick Jameer Nelson. Now, check out Rich with this crazy dunk. The playoffs, man. I ain't even want to see the replay, man. It seems like with every little stupid animation, when Dwight Howard is in the game, man, everything bad can happen. Now, check this out. Booker misses an easy wide-open jump shot, and guess what happens? Hito comes down and get a fast break layup with nobody stopping him. I didn't know what to do. All I could do was take a timeout. I just had to regroup, man. It was that serious, man. So now, coming back, Hito pulling up for threes. These guys take three after three after three. The name of this video should have been Live or Die by the Three because they shoot so many three-pointers. But check out that nice dunk. Woo! Dwight Howard should have got a foul called on him right there, but you know, it's all good. I'll take that. I'll take the 2 points. Now, check out Hito. Another three-pointer, man. It disappoints me to see how many threes that this team takes. But you know what we got? We got fast break threes as well, man. What I wanted to do, I didn't want to go in the paint as much this game. I really wanted to get it out to all of my teammates and see if we can shoot threes with these guys. Now, check out the nice up and under. This move right here is two cheese, man. I killed that team. Quadruple single. Quadruple what? Whatever. All right. Look, check this out. I got a nice little pick going on. Now, I wanted to pass it to Booker, but he was doing too much. So I gave it to Kmart, and guess what he did? He finished. He did what I wanted him to do. We finally got a three-point lead. We're about to get a four-point lead if he could hit this free throw right here. This right here is what made the game. Now, with that foul, it kind of helped our team out. You know, it sent somebody to the bench. Dwight is still in, but it is what it is. Now, Richardson with another goddamn three-pointer. Now, Dwight Howard has his fourth, but we lose a good teammate. The thing about Nocioni is he's a power forward, right? So now with him out, we don't have a true power forward in the game. So this kind of hurt me a little bit. So I really didn't know what to do until, you know, we got Nocioni back. I did check to see the stat line, and he is hurt, but he did come back later on. Now, did you check out that three-pointer? These guys are pulling three-pointers in people's face for no apparent reason. But after he misses that foul line, we out on the break. You already know what I'm about to do. Dom City, baby. That was a nice cut, beautiful cut, and it was a nice finish. I wish he would have got the foul, but...
As the fourth quarter gets going, let's swing it over to Doris Burke, who has our Sprite Spark Report. Doris?
And Kevin, for that great stretch the Magic put together, they get the Sprite Spark Award. That big second quarter is where they took control, and they haven't slowed up since.
Okay, Doris, thank you. And that run, Clark, really changed the complexion of this game.
All right, you guys. In the fourth quarter, you already know what I want to do, man. I want to take back the momentum. We have lost all momentum. We're at home. We're down 10. I want to take back the momentum. I got 10 assists. It doesn't matter how many assists, how many points I got. I need my teammates to bring the momentum back. We need to play great defense, and we need to play efficient offense. Now, check out Hito Turkoglu trying to cheese on me. You can't let that one fly, man. Come on. So you already knew what I had to do, man. Nice left-hand layup. I'm going in the people's chest. You already know how I play. I play to win. Now, I don't know why Jameer Nelson is trying to post moves, but it's cool with me. Let's get out on a break. Now, with that foul right there, Guess what happens? Jameer Nelson gets his fifth personal foul with 7 minutes to go in the quarter. Now, you can also see that Dwight Howard goes back to the bench. That's because Dwight Howard has 5 fouls as well. So, we're really winning right now on the low. So, you know, we're fighting to come back because their prime time guys, two of them are out. All we got to worry about now is Hedo and Richardson. Now, right there, you can see that he goes in for the cut. No foul call. We can take that, you know. Now, check out Hedo forcing it, man. Thanks a lot, Hedo. High five to Hedo, man. Hedo, for some reason, this match, he was really forcing the issue. I didn't know what it was, but, like, I don't know, man. Maybe he really wanted to take all the weight, man, really. Hedo, he just wanted to keep shooting. He really wasn't trying to be efficient in passing anymore, so I really saw what type of player he was becoming in the fourth. Now, check this out. We got 1 minute left in the game. This right here, I don't know what's about to happen. 5 seconds left on the clock. Check out what Jay Rich does. He doesn't even try to pass it. That's how selfish these guys have been all game, man, shooting threes after threes after threes. Now, look, check out Dwight Howard. I don't even know why he's in the game trying to dribble the ball. You got Bass up top shooting threes. What's going on with this game, man? What's going on, 2K? I don't understand, man. What's up? Now, you already know what we're doing right now. We're going to the foul line. Going for these five-second free throws. What they call it, proof of Hall of Fame? Team five-second free throws, man. We in here. You already know what it is, man. We took the momentum back. The Magic had the momentum all game long. And I'm glad that us as a team could hold on to the momentum, take it back, and win this game. It's a great win. I love it. You gotta love it, man. I just want to thank everybody for watching this video. Check out for game 3 at Orlando.
So the 76ers win it. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respectable performances on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I think it was just really a nice overall effort, Kevin.
Well, that'll do it for now. Thanks for watching our coverage of the first round of the NBA playoffs. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long. We leave you now with our Jordan Player of the Game.
Check out some ending stats right here, man. Hedo Turkoglu 6 for 10. Jay Richardson 3 for 12. Duhon 3 for 6. Come on. Look at this, man. We only took a total of what? 6? You know what? This game is crazy. Hold on. Wait. Let's see how many three-pointers this team really took. Come on. 38? Come on. 38 three-pointers attempts? Come on, man. 38? And I'm still playing injured, man. Wait till I get to 100%, man. We gonna make the playoffs popping, man. Let's go.
You guys took care of business at home, winning the first two games and putting the pressure on the other guys to hold serve on their home court. What's the plan for this team to try to steal one on the road?
Coach put together a real good game plan for us. And if we stick with that, there's no reason to think we can't win at least one of these games on the road. I felt like this team was better prepared than we've ever been. And when you've got that much confidence in your coaching staff, it makes everything just a little easier.